There's more and more interest in MASH due to the success of GLP-1. A lot of people now in pharma and biotech are interested in metabolic disease. MASH, metabolic disease of the liver, is very attractive because there's no real therapy.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Genflow Biosciences CEO, Dr. Eric Leire. Eric, very good to speak with you. You're preparing for clinical trial authorization in Europe for GF1002. How close are you to that milestone, and what's the next steps?
Yes, you're right, Stefan. We put our priority on the European Medicines Agency rather than the FDA and the filing for clinical trial authorization. This CTA, clinical trial authorization, is a huge step in MASH, in our MASH program, because if you want to increase evaluation of a program and therefore the company, it's very important to have data in human. We have good data in animal models, but that does not correlate with an increase in valuation of the company. For the street to put money, high valuation on the company, we need to have proof efficacy in human, and therefore it's super important for us to move to as fast as possible to clinical trial authorization. I can say that we're moving with confidence to this filing. We're building this filing with a lot of confidence, mostly because the big part of the filing is the CMC, the manufacturing and the control, and we're moving with our CDMO Exothera. We have a long relationship with Exothera. They're local. We are very close. And we are extremely confident because we had a test already in bioreactor and we had better than expected yield. So this is very safe for us and give us some peace of mind regarding this filing. Also regarding this filing, we have a different approach. Usually the second most important part of the filing is to have a pivotal study that demonstrate efficacy in animal models. And you do that with an independent CRO. We do that with two CROs. It's not because we want to waste our money, but because MASH is an evolving disease. And the entry point in MASH is very important. There's more and more interest in MASH due to the success of GLP-1. A lot of people now in pharma and biotech are interested in metabolic disease. MASH, metabolic disease of the liver, is very attractive because there's no real therapy. So we face some competition, which is very good and healthy. Having a program with Physiogenex for early stage entry and with Accelera for late stage entry give us the opportunity to discuss with the European agency what will be the best strategy to enter. The late stage is a smaller market, but less competition and allow us to have higher pricing. Early stage, we face more competition, so more difficulty to enroll patients and potential more competitor in the future market, but a larger market. We'll have this discussion with the European Agency very soon, and I hope it will be very interesting for us.
Eric, also in today's update, you've announced that you've amended the protocol for your GF1004 dog trial. What's the thinking behind that change, and what are you hoping to learn from this study?
Yes, the dog study is ongoing, and we made a first amendment to the protocol. As soon as it's a very controlled study, it's randomized, it's comparative, it's also run by an independent CROs, and quite happy with the way it progressed. We thought it was very important to have this first amendment. The first amendment is a little bit technical. It specifies the rate of infusion, the speed where you infuse the gene therapy to the dog. Why that? It's very important to have the most consistency in the way the drug is infused to the dog. But most importantly, it's very important to give more guidance for the future use by private veterinary. And we want to have some very good guidelines so the veterinarian will be very comfortable administrating the drug. It's quite important because that will be a major point for the partnership with an animal health company. We're still looking to have a partnership as soon as we finish this study with an animal health company. That will bring all again some non-diluting funding to the company. So good news for the investors.
Eric, I hope you'll keep us posted on progress with both of those programs. Thank you very much for the update today.
Thank you. We're very happy with that. We have some tailwind. The new rules from the FDA, from the FCA, regarding the emission of new shares coming in January is very good news. So we benefit right now from tailwind, and it's a pleasure to share with you the advance in our program. Thank you, Stefan.
Thanks again, Eric. That's Dr. Eric Leire. He's the CEO of Genflow Biosciences.